Hello everyone, I'm Avalost and welcome to my channel. Today's episode might be interesting for those playing on large single screens such as 55-inch TVs or Samsung Arc monitors. I will show you how to better utilize your screen and increase the performance of your graphics card, which wastes some of its resources displaying the car roof that no one is looking at. I'm not claiming that the solution is better than triple screens or ultra-wide setups, but I'm presenting it as an interesting alternative that works perfect for me. For more details, check the description below the video, and let's get started. To start, let's move the Windows taskbar from the bottom to the top of the screen. This is helpful because the rig might block some important elements at the bottom. Next, right-click on the desktop and select Personalize. Navigate to the Colors tab. Here, check the box that applies colors to window titles and borders. Then, choose a dark color. Be aware that picking a very dark color might affect the readability of certain Windows elements, but it's a trade-off. Personally, I went with an even darker custom color for a better effect. Once that's done, you can close the settings and open the registry editor by typing regedit in the search bar. In the registry editor, navigate to the DWM folder. Right click, select new, DWORD 32-bit. After creating the DWORD, double click on it and set its value to 1. Then find accent color and enter the color code EC050505. Pure black might not work. After that, you can close the registry editor. Land the game in windowed mode and check the results. You should see that the title bar is almost black and the window borders are very dark. Now let's install software to manage screen areas. Before that, I recommend using a wallpaper that helps with the next setup. Open Microsoft Store and download Microsoft Power Toys. After installing, launch it and turn off all modules except fancy zones. Go to Fancy Zones settings and check the following options. Window scaling when snipping into zones while holding shift. Keep windows in their zones when resolution changes. Move newly opened windows to their last zone, and this is crucial. And allow snipping of all windows. Once done, close the settings and proceed to configure fancy zones. In the new window that appears, click on Add New Layout. I'm going to load a layout I've saved. Disable the spacing around zones. And enter the layout editor. Here you can manually adjust the size of zones using sliders. For example, zone 2 is a bit above 1600 pixels to account for Windows title bar. You can adjust the zone after launching the game. After configuring the layout, close it and test if Fancy Zones is working as expected. Now shrink the game window and drag it to Zone 2 while holding the Shift key. As you can see, it works great. When you relaunch the game, it will automatically return to this zone. Note that not every game supports this feature, but I'll discuss that later. Now let's talk about telemetry. For this, you'll need the SimHub application. If you don't have it yet, now it's a good time to install it. The dashboard I've created is available for my Patreons, but with online tutorials you can create a similar one yourself. To set it up, open Dash Studio in SimHub, select the dashboard you want and pick New Save at Location. Personally, I prefer the Add Game Connection Startup option, but the most important settings is to choose Startup Location as Fixed Coordinates. Then select Open Dashboard, set its location and size, and click Save Current Coordinates. These settings will ensure the telemetry dashboard appears automatically in the right place. Now let's discuss compatibility. Not every game supports custom resolution or saving windows in selected zones. For example, Automobilista doesn't allow you to choose custom resolutions or save window placement from its settings. As shown in the video, you can handle resolution, but you'll need to manually move the window to the bottom of the screen. I haven't checked if other games have this problem, like Automobilista, but games like Assetto Corsa or Assetto Corsa Competizione will automatically resize the game window to fit the zone, even if the resolution is different in game settings. For Automobilista, you can open the Automobilista 2 folder in your documents and edit the settings file using Notepad. You can copy the settings shown in the video if you want. That's all for today. Let me know in the comments if you liked the video and if you found it useful. You can find more information about my setup and settings in the video description. Take care and see you next time.